Nazi technology was terrifying and often superior to that of the Allies. It was on Germany, not Japan, that the United States first intended to drop an atomic bomb on account of Hitler having his own nuclear program. But Nazi technology could also be really, really weird. Also willing to try new things, German scientists and engineers theorized and built a number of rather bizarre weapons. Here are the five strangest experimental Nazi weapons. Number 5 is the Scherwerer-Gustav Railway Gun. A railway gun is a huge piece of artillery which requires parallel sets of railway track to transport it. Railway guns were far from uncommon, as many countries possessed them. However, the German version, named the Scherwerer-Gustav or Heavy Gustav, truly went above and beyond. The artillery piece was 4 stories tall, bore a barrel 100 feet long, and fired a 31-inch shell, making it the largest caliber rifle weapon ever used in combat. It could effectively fire almost 9 miles and was meant to disable heavily fortified French forts on the Maginot Line. However, it was not completed in time for the invasion of France, and it didn't see action until the siege of Sevastopol. The drawbacks, however, were significant. The Gustav gun took at least a half an hour to reload. It was slow to transport because a special railway had to be built in order to get the Gustav gun into a firing position. The barrel of the gun could not rotate, so the track had to be built to point the weapon at a desired target. While the Gustav gun's large size and lack of mobility made it vulnerable to bombardment, it somehow managed to survive to the end of the war. However, the Gustav gun met an unceremonious end when the Germans blew it up in order to prevent its capture. Number 4 is the V3 cannon. Size apparently did matter to the Nazis. Apparently not content with the Scherwerer-Gustav, engineers developed the V3 cannon, a 430-foot-long monstrosity meant to strike the enemy from up to 100 miles away. Specifically, it was meant to hit London from the north shores of France, although RAF bombers took out the site before the weapon could be used. The problem with conventional weapons is the immense amount of explosive power necessary to fire projectiles extremely long distances. These explosions quickly damage the weapons, requiring intensive maintenance. The V3 was able to dial back the power of any one explosion by using a series of explosions along the barrel as the projectile advanced, each adding its power to the projectile's propulsion. The V3 could fire 300-pound shells at almost 5,000 feet per second. Theoretically, it could have fired 300 times every hour, although this was never tested. Smaller versions of the V3 did see action in World War II, specifically in Luxembourg. Number 3 is the Sun Gun. Nothing says supervillain like planning to build an impossibly big weapon in space. The Nazis had plans for a sun gun, which was a space station armed with a giant mirror to direct and focus the sun's heat to burn cities and boil oceans. This is where Hitler should be twirling his mustache, but we all know his mustache was far too short to twirl. In reality, the sun gun was a very far-fetched plan and never made it off the drawing board. The idea of the sun gun was simply too far ahead of its time. The first satellites didn't go up until more than a decade after the war, and the first space station wasn't operational until 1973. But all those hurdles pale in comparison to the 3.5 square miles of metallic sodium that would have been needed to produce the mirror for the sun gun. Number 2 is the Zeppelin Rammer. Despite what it sounds like, the Zeppelin Rammer was not meant to ram Zeppelins, nor was it a Zeppelin itself. The Zeppelin Rammer was a plane meant to ram other planes. It just happened to be built by the same company that produced Zeppelins. The Rammer was towed into the air by a conventional plane, then released. Igniting a rocket engine, it then bore down on enemy bombers. The reinforced fuselage was meant to survive the impact, and the pilot would then glide the plane to safety on the ground. However, the Zeppelin factory building the Rammers was destroyed by the Allied bombings before any of these strange suicide planes could be completed, so we'll never know how astoundingly good or suicidally bad the Rammer could have been. Number 1 is the Kumlauf. Ever read a comic book where the superhero bends rifle barrels to keep them from firing? The Nazis proved that doesn't necessarily work. The Kumlauf was a barrel attachment for assault rifles which bent 30, 45, 60, or 90 degrees. The purpose was to grant the average soldier the ability to fire at their enemies from a position of safety around corners, and bizarrely enough, the attachment was actually effective. The problem with the Kumlauf was that a 45-degree barrel could only fire about 160 rounds before failing, and the rounds that did make it through the Kommenauf also tended to fracture, which made the device better suited to the role of a shotgun rather than a method of firing around corners with precision. For more top lists just like this, be sure to leave a like and subscribe if you haven't already, and don't forget to check out our other lists, and thanks for watching, and thanks for learning.